Shalom. Welcome to Kenya's Jamhuri Day 2021 virtual celebration in commemoration of our independence. 58 years ago, on the 12th December 1963, at midnight, the Kenyan flag replaced the Union Jack. For the first time, our national anthem, a rallying prayer for blessing, justice, peace, and liberty, was beamed across the country. A year later, on the same day, Kenya became a republic. This Uhuru, meaning freedom, had been won through a long struggle and a painful war. On this day, we reflect on the sacrifices made by our many heroes and heroines to whom we shall be forever indebted. In 58 years, Kenya has made significant strides in political and socio-economic development. It is a thriving multi-party democracy, currently a non-permanent member of the UN Security Council and a regional anchor of peace and security. Kenya's socio-economic development is defined in the economic blueprint, the Vision 2030. At independence, for example, Kenya's GDP was below $1 billion. Today, it is $110 billion. This makes Kenya the sixth wealthiest nation in the continent of Africa. Also to note is that despite challenges posed by COVID-19 outbreak and its impact on the global economy, Kenya's economy remained resilient, with the government injecting economic recovery stimulus packages. In 2020, at the height of the pandemic, our economy grew at 0.3%, while in the second quarter of 2021, the real GDP recorded a phenomenal 10.1% growth, with contributing sectors being the ICT, transport, and manufacturing. A strategically located regional hub with high internet connectivity, modern infrastructure for air, rail, and road transportation, two major seaports, Mombasa and Lamu, and an inland port, Lake Victoria, connecting Eastern and Central Africa to the Indian Ocean. Investing in Kenya gives access to East African community and commercial markets with a population of 126 million and 430 million respectively, a big market for any investor. People have noticed these statistics that I've just given you. Last month, the European Union Bank, it opened its first regional hub of European Union in Nairobi, which will cover 11 countries in Eastern and Central Africa. Like everybody knows, to invest, you need a workforce. And Kenya has a large pool of youthful, well-educated, and skilled labor force, has a well-established and vibrant private sector coupled with fully liberalized economy, a regional leader in fintech, especially mobile phone money-based transfer. Kenya is home to the renowned M-Pesa innovation. The main thing here is the Vision 2030 economic blueprint, which aims to make Kenya globally competitive and offers many opportunities for any long-term investor. Already in the short term, the Big Four agenda covering food and nutrition security, manufacturing, universal healthcare coverage, and affordable housing are low-lying fruits. There are also opportunities for investment in tourism, hotel and hospitality industry, the blue economy, financial services, energy and petroleum, mining and mineral sector, among many others, all attractive to any long-term investor. Yeah, the reason why there's a lot of talk about Kenya and renewable energy is because we have managed to achieve currently a 73% renewable energy usage with a target of achieving 100% by the year 2030. For example, one major stride that we did in Kenya, which a lot of people doubted whether it would work or not, and it has worked, it is the outlawing of use, manufacture, and importation of single-use plastic bags as a way to protect our environment. We recognize that climate change is not a future problem, but a present and serious threat to countries across the world. We are therefore developing a robust climate change action plan to scale up efforts and maintain low carbon emission. Kenya and Israel relationship is an enduring and cordial one, and it is historical. This relationship started pre our independence, where 2 days to our independence, that is on 10th December 1963, the late President, His Excellency Mzee Jomo Kenyatta, and the former Minister for Foreign Affairs, Golda Meir, laid a foundation stone for the current Israeli embassy in Kenya. Kenya and Israel have over the years exchanged high-level visits. For example, in January 1994, the late President, Daniel Toroitich Arap Moi, visited Israel. And in March of the same year, we opened our embassy in Israel. Most recent, in 2016, His Excellency President Uhuru Kenyatta also paid a visit to Israel. And soon after, there was a reciprocal visit by His Excellency, the former Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu in 2016, June. Also, the Prime Minister visited Kenya again in November of 2017. Actually, the relationship between Kenya and Israel defines what many say that a friend in need is a friend indeed. And I'll just give you two examples. The Entebbe Raid in 1976, during the hostage rescue by Israel, Kenya proved to be a true friend to Israel. And in 1998, when we had embassy bombings by terrorists in Nairobi, Israel was the first country within a very short time to respond, to report on site and join Kenyans in search and rescue operations. Such events, such reactions are what define a true and cordial relationship. Our bilateral relations continue to flourish once again. And this is because we have cooperation in many sectors, in agriculture, water and irrigation, defense and security, trade and education, health, energy, science and technology. We relate very closely with Israel, Kenya and Israel, where we also learn from each other on modern ways of doing all these things. One very interesting example of this relationship that also is contributing in a big way to what I mentioned, our Vision 2030, the Big Four agenda, and especially the agenda on food security, is that for the last 4 years, Israel has been training young Kenyans drawn from our universities in advanced agricultural methods. This is done at Tarava, ICAT, and the 11-month program gives them knowledge, what is defined as learning by doing, practical lessons, skills which are very important for future development. Currently, we actually have 149 young students who have come in for the 2021-2022 cohort. This, again, we appreciate because, like I said, it is a direct impact on our food security agenda. Kenyan tourism offers you with a cocktail of things you can do, enjoy yourself. And this is defined by Kenyan's terrain and topography. For example, you can just decide to go to the coast, enjoy the sandy beaches, or you can decide to drive inlands through the savanna grasslands and be able to view within a very short time what everybody talks about, the Big Five. And I'm sure you've heard about the Lion King, a product of Kenya. After that, someone else may decide, my interest is not the Big Five. My interest is mountain climbing. And you have a choice of three mountains. To the south, with our border in Tanzania, the highest mountain in Africa, Kilimanjaro, you can approach from Kenya. And Kenya is also home to the other two. The second highest mountain, Mount Kenya, a unique mountain across the equator, but snow-capped. The equator passes on the middle of Mount Kenya, but it has snow cap. And also you can go to the northwest and climb Mount Elgon. The other features. Of course, Kenya is home to the Rift Valley that starts somewhere in Israel. And the Rift Valley has got abundant areas of interest through the topography, the Rift Valley Lakes, where again you can do all types of sports, enjoy yourself. Also, people come to Kenya because of one unique phenomenon that exists in Kenya. In our western country, the famous Kakamega Forest actually offers you an opportunity, if you are a bird watcher, to see the highest number of different types of birds in 1 hour. And of course, everybody knows that the eighth wonder of the New World, the wild beast migration, is right there in front of you if you visit Kenya, Masai Mara. We actually invite everyone to make it a goal to visit Kenya in their lifetime. On my own behalf, my family, the entire staff of the Kenyan Embassy in Israel, and Kenya's Honorary Counsel, Mr. Shlomo Grofman, I take this opportunity to wish you all a Merry Christmas, a happy and prosperous New Year 2022. And now, to commemorate our 58th anniversary of Kenya's independence, I wish to request you to raise a glass and toast to the good health of our readers and to the continued warm relationships between our two countries.
Happy Jamhuri Day!